Hey guys, welcome to Let's Play Gargoyle's Quest, released in 1990 on the Game Boy by Capcom. It's the first in a trilogy of games that's a spin-off of the Ghosts and Goblins series. It was also released in Japan as Makai Murugaiden, Red Armor, and it's an action platformer with mild RPG elements. So without further delay, let's begin the game. Well, things are already looking bad already. Oh dear. And this is our main character, Firebrand, a red gargoyle demon, who's also a prominent enemy in the Ghosts and Goblins series, and has probably pissed off many a fan of that particular series here. So now we begin our intro stage, and this is Firebrand. He can jump, and he can shoot a basic fire shot, and by holding jump in the air, you can hover, though that drains your wing meter on the bottom of the screen. You'll also see his life meter there, with two little circles. So two hits, and Firebrand dies. So be very careful in this level. You get more hits as the game progresses, but not for a while. Now this here is a vial. You can exchange vials in towns for extra lives. And believe me, you might want to do that, because this game can get rather tricky if you're not careful. Firebrand also has the ability to stick onto walls and jump off them like so, a mechanic that will be used many a time to progress through the game. Damn it. Grab this vial here. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay, because we'll just see what I mean here. Just get up here, and there's a heart! As you may guess, hearts replenish lost life. So we'll just grab that and do a nice fall right back down to that wall. Yeah, there you go. Haha. Nothing to it, see? Nothing to it. These enemies are kind of a pain, too. Ugh. Just hover down there. Shoot those two guys. Get rid of that. Now, this is a classic platformer trick. Blocks that fall. I'm not going to bother to go get that vial. It's too much of a hassle. You get plenty of vials as the game progresses, so if you don't want to go for one, it's okay. You'll make up for it, I'm sure. Now down there is where you would come up from if you fell down where that vial was and couldn't get back up. So it's just a quick little branching path, nothing too special. Here is water, and you sink in it, but you don't drown. And if there's a lot of it, you can do infinite jumps. Now that little hover through the spikes right there is something of a trademark of this game. You'll have to do a lot of that as you go through. And we're near the end of the level here. Just carefully attempt to grab his heart. Hover over these spikes, and we're at the boss already. Zundo Drewer, a giant blowfish thing that just pops out of the water. Basically, what I do here is I just stand on this platform, wait for him to come up, and then just shoot him. Then when he comes back down, you can just sink in the water. You get even more chances to just whack him. To smash the living hell out of him. Sometimes he does this, which is kind of annoying. But I got a good hit on him, so that's okay. It's okay. Ah, fucker. Just keep going like that. Really not a hard boss at all. Most of these bosses can just be tanked, except for a few, which are kind of tricky. But again, you'll see exactly what I mean. And Zundo Drewer is dead. Hooray for victory fanfare. Ground rises up, and this giant door opens, allowing us to get back to the Ghoul Realm. Goodness, we're on an overworld again. This is the mild RPG element I was talking about. We'll explore more of that next time on Let's Play Gargoyle's Quest. I'm Freezing Inferno, glad you watched, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now, guys!